It is empowering, or at least therapeutic, in these dark times, to imagine what a time-literate society might look like. In his last public interview, Kurt Vonnegut said, "I'll tell you, one thing no cabinet has ever had is a secretary of the future, and there are no plans at all for my grandchildren and my great-grandchildren." Let us adopt Vonnegut's suggestion as our first proposal, a representative for the yet-to-be-born to serve among the top advisors to the president. The Department of the Future would set in motion a realignment of priorities in all aspects of society. And now we should cue some triumphant music, I think. The secretary will declare some new national holidays, Aldo Leopold, Rachel Carson, or Chief Seattle Days, to honor great long-term thinkers. Photosynthesis and Carbonate Rock Week, a time to celebrate the mighty legions of coccolithophores and others who have kept the planet from becoming a runaway greenhouse. Resource conservation would again become a core value and patriotic virtue. Tax incentives and subsidies would be rebalanced toward rewarding long-term stewardship over short-term exploitation. Putting a price on carbon will help us get a grip on our fossil fuel addiction, sober up, and let us prepare for the natural disasters that will happen without our assistance, like the hundreds of large earthquakes that will happen around the globe in the next century, rather than expending resources on self-created climate catastrophes. Poverty and class-based disparity of opportunity would be recognized as problems with deep historical roots that cannot be solved without sustained commitment over commensurate timescales into the future. Public school teachers and others whose work represents an investment in the future would be paid well and held in high esteem. Geology would be fully integrated into science curricula. Perhaps serving as a capstone course in which students would apply physics, chemistry, and biology to the immensely complex Earth system. With a solid understanding of how the planet works, students would go on to become educated voters who would hold public officials accountable for wise governance of water, land, and air. Legislators, governors, and mayors who embrace the seven-generation principle would point proudly to what they are doing and be re-elected by grateful constituents. More generally, schools would help develop children's knowledge of and appetite for history and natural history, instilling in them a deep instinct for their place in time and a keen curiosity to understand more.